Hi guys, so let's go back to Kibbe series. If you're new, I'm gonna leave the link on my Kibbe playlist down below. And today we're gonna talk about the confusions about the body types. I'm sure there are much more confusions than that, but I just thought of several most popular ones. So from my viewpoint, the biggest confusion there is that if the person has some kind of overweight or some kind of softness, then she's romantic. I even saw dramatic women who thought they were romantic women just because of that softness. So every time they could see some puffiness on their face, for example, on their waist, on their hips, on their legs or arms, they were thinking about their flesh being soft flesh. So this is the biggest mistake number one, because Kibbe is not about the shape, about the overweight. Doesn't matter if you're overweight or underweight, you still have a certain bone structure and you still have a certain yin and yang balance, not only in your physical body, also in your essence. Kibbe talks a lot about essence. And what we're trying to see is we're trying to understand the bone structure underneath that softness. If, let's say, you have this period of your life that you're overweight, you still have a certain bone structure and certain combination of yin or yang in that body, in your personality, in your essence, that create this or that body type. And every type overweights differently. And we're gonna talk about this in one of my next videos, so stay tuned. I'll give you an example. So look at that woman, you see? So she's soft, but it's not necessarily that her bone structure is romantic bone structure, because romantics, they have pretty short bones. They have pretty short and wide bones. They're not blunt bones, not squarish, not angular. Pretty soft. Everything is slightly rounded, slightly delicate at the same time. And that is the biggest difficulty. I think only David Kibbe can say that. For me too, sometimes it's hard to understand. I need to see a lot of pictures. Sometimes I need to see hands and feet to understand. So sometimes, you know, that bone structure on your hands and feet can really give you a hint. When I do photo session, for example, or if I film videos, I can make many different faces on myself, many different haircuts, hairstyles. And especially with filming the videos or doing photo session, I can look pretty different. Like I can look like this type more, or like this type more. I can make myself look pretty feminine sometimes, especially on the photos, because on the video I'm still speaking, you can see my gestures, I'm not super feminine, right? But on the pictures, I can do sometimes that. I can change my bone structure with those two powders, brown powder and lighter powder. I can change my face, I can change my bone structure, kind of like an illusion. But as soon as you see my hand, you can understand what I'm talking about, right? So it's a pretty short, boyish, square hand. I have pretty strong hands, pretty short, pretty square. So that can't be any romantic or anything like that. So that is another hint. But at the same time, don't only judge by your hands. I know many people will start like, oh, but my hands look like theatrical romantic, therefore I'm theatrical romantic. Of course not. It's still, it's a balance and it's a majority of things. That is not that easy to see at the first glance. So I do understand you very much. Second thing, many people who are interested in this subject, in Kibbe body types, they think that this is that body types technique system that they've heard before. Like hourglass figure, asparagus, triangle, rectangle, pear shape, right? So this is all have been categorized, but Kibbe system is not about this. Yeah, he considers that sometimes. Of course he considers that. But again, it's one of many things that are in a certain combination give you this or that type. So that's another thing that I could see, that so many people who have some kind of difference between their waist and their hips, they consider it to be hourglass. So they consider themselves as classics or romantics. And dramatics also can have some difference between their waist and hips. Flamboyant naturals, like this example, Gigi Hadid, right? She is a flamboyant natural type. And the shape of her hips, actually, they are slightly straight, but then she has that thinner waist. But it's just one element of the whole look. She has vertical line, she has the shape of her bones, the width of her bones, the length of her bones, the structure of her face, the structure of her shoulders, the chest area, her hands and feet, her, I don't know, nose, lips, chin, everything else. So all that is a combination of things, and that creates a flamboyant natural out of her, even though many people can say, yes, she has that hourglass figure. So sometimes I even ask people to forget about those figures, like just forget about this and try to analyze something else that they have. Because many people base that on that only one knowledge that they had before. Kibbe is about yin and yang balance. And what does it mean? Yang, it's a male energy. Yin, it's a female energy. It's a very ancient theory about two energies that everything in this world consists of. Yang or yin, they have their own characteristics. Yin is soft, rounded, short, small. Yang is tall, straight, stronger. Actually, Kibbe has, in his book, he has a list of those characteristics of yin and yang. We're gonna talk about this later too. And so by analyzing your particular body, you have to analyze just every single piece of your body. And I know sometimes it's pretty hard to do, but luckily everybody has a phone now with a camera. You put the phone several steps away from yourself. You make a picture of yourself. You place the camera approximately the chest level because the angle should be very straight. If we make a picture of you from the bottom or from the top, then your proportions will be changed. You won't be able to analyze yourself. So as other people, right? So to really understand yourself, sometimes you have to compare even your picture to picture, like for example, to you, to celebrities or to your friend who also made same picture, and you just place those pictures together on the phones or the computer. The most important thing is just to make approximate height of those people. You place the picture so the legs are standing at the same level, and then the height, so approximately the height would be same. This is how you can compare. You can compare yourself to so many people and you can see your proportions much better. You know, I always thought that I was curvy. I always thought that I had hourglass figure. As soon as I started learning about this Kibbe system, I was super curious about how I look. And then for the first time in my life, I decided to compare myself. And I found a picture of Marilyn Monroe where she stands just straight like that, so we could see all her curves like that. And then I made a picture of myself, pretty similar, also several steps away from the phone, and then I put it on my computer. We are the same height with Marilyn. So when I placed those two pictures on my computer, I placed my feet and her feet at the same level, and my head and her head at the same level, so we would be absolutely same size. And I placed her and I placed myself. I was so shocked how straight I was. I was so shocked how vertical my lines were on my body, on my hips. My hips were really vertical. I still have chest, and then I have smaller waist, and then I have hips, but this is much more to it. Like my hips comparing to Marilyn's, I was like a boy, you know. Again, Kibbe says don't compare yourself to other people. We don't compare yourself to other people. You look at yourself within yourself. But sometimes to train your eyes, you won't be able to say, for example, what is classic, what does it mean symmetry, what does it mean proportionate, what does it mean proportions. What kind of proportions classic has then? Another mistake that some people make is they like everybody told them that they look like one of the or the other celebrity, or they think they look like this celebrity. But they can be different body type with this celebrity. They can be totally different body types because the bone structure, for example, can be super different. The yin and yang balance can be absolutely different. It's just some features of the faces can be very similar, which is totally fine. It happens. Let's say you are romantic and you know for sure. You know, sometimes you can really look like a dramatic, like a celebrity dramatic woman. You will be so similar, but what will be different is totally different yin and yang balance. So both of you will look completely different in the same clothes, in the same type of clothes or silhouette. One of you can look bulky, another of you will look elegant, or one of you can look very feminine, or the other one will look very heavy in that type of clothes, you know? Another confusion that I see very often is that many people put themselves into classic category because they think, like for themselves, they are pretty much average. For example, they look at their own facial features and for them, they are evenly spaced. So that is enough for many people to say that they are classics. Also, many people think that they are classics because they have difference between their waist and hips. They are not super small, they are not super tall. Nothing in their appearance is too much or too prominent or too recognizable. So they think because of that, they are classics, which is in so many cases is not true. Again, yin and yang balance. And actually, I see those mistakes not only when people are trying to type themselves, but also there are other people on YouTube or bloggers somewhere there in internet who are typing other people. Be careful with that, because 80% from what I saw, they typed wrong. Because, for example, there's a flamboyant natural girl with blunt bone structure. She's obviously flamboyant natural. And professionals who try to type that, they said she was classic just because she had that pretty evenly spaced facial features. Another thing when people get confused, they sometimes look at celebrities, Kibbe's list celebrities. When they search for their pictures, they look on their pictures and they see their style as their type. So they can't separate a person and clothes and makeup and hair that they are wearing. So very often people are analyzing the look, but not the type, not the type. And that is pretty tricky. At the beginning, I also was caught in that trap. Very often, sometimes some people, let's say they look like they make that gamin style, but they are romantic or soft natural. But people say, oh, she's a gamin because she has that short hair, she has that color blocks, small details and like sharp silhouettes or something, narrow silhouettes, color blocks. But no, she is soft natural. So she's wearing that and she looks more or less okay, but she's still soft natural. I'll give you an example now, but it's pretty extreme, but you will get what I'm talking about. So Olsen sisters. So I've seen in Kibbe celebrities list, official list, I think they are soft gamins. Correct me if I'm wrong. I also see them as soft gamins, and they're pretty skinny, you know? They lost a lot of weight, so you can even see their ribs, like they're super skinny. Sharper shoulders, sharper chin, a jawline. The style they choose very often is flamboyant natural style, which is totally opposite. That's their expression. This is how they express themselves. So it's wonderful. It's awesome. But you see what I mean? So the style itself, it doesn't say that the person is this body type. So one of the best things that you can train yourself in is try to separate the body and the style. If celebrities are shot with paparazzi, it can tell you sometimes something if the shot is from the front, but very often it's angled, so it's hard to say. You can still see how this or that person looks in that type of clothes that they're wearing every day in their life. Another thing, I prefer looking for pictures in bikini on the beach. So those pictures normally can show you a lot of things. Even if she was shot in bikini for a photo session, then these kind of pictures were photoshopped again. They were photoshopped pretty heavily sometimes. Very often they make their waist thinner, the hips rounder, I don't know, softer or even smaller sometimes for some women if they don't want that. So the picture changes completely and then you judge based upon that. This way soft natural can turn to romantic. Because every blunt bone is softened. Sometimes outfit can be so not for this type, so they feel like they need to Photoshop more. Or, for example, romantic Kate Winslet. She did many things to look gorgeous in this photo session when she looks like a dramatic. It looks amazing, but she still is romantic, so she still looks in real life. I don't know what she did with her cheeks, whether she did some operation, but I think maybe she just lost a lot of weight, so she has those shadows also were added with makeup, and then a certain makeup, certain hair, she lost weight, she was wearing that suit, certain lighting, all that created that amazing thing, made her look more dramatic, but she is still romantic. And if we see her just like that on the street without any makeup, with her natural hair, we will still perceive her as romantic. And also I can say red carpet are not telling us much about the body type. Sometimes it can be obvious, sometimes not. Sometimes you have to really wash that thing off her face. Ask her stand straight without any heels, high heels, Photoshop, without any angle or posing or trying to look pretty or trying to look taller, cuter, I don't know, sexier. or trying to look more curvy. All that is tricks on how to look slightly different, which is also great. If you look better like this or that, or you found your angle, that's amazing. But we are talking about a real life situation where people have their real bone structure, basically, and their real yin and yang balance in life. That's why I try to find very raw pictures. So please let me know, guys, if you have other confusions, and I'm gonna make another video about other confusions. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe on my Pinterest for 13 boards as an inspiration for the body types. Also, you can subscribe on my Instagram. All the links I'm gonna leave down below. Also, you can become my sponsor or subscribe on my Patreon for some exclusive videos, some early access to these videos, and just if you want to support me and my channel. Thank you so much, guys, and I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye.